In this video, I'm going to show you how to diagnose frozen shoulder. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Frozen shoulder has a prevalence of 2 to 5.3% in the general population, with a peak at 55 years of age, and a higher prevalence amongst women, patients with diabetes and thyroid dysfunction, and a previous episode of frozen shoulder on the contralateral side. The patho-anatomical features of frozen shoulder are angiogenesis into the capsule tissue, which produces collagen fiber proliferation, granulation, and contracture of the capsular ligamentous complex. According to Fastamäki et al. In the year 2012, 94% of the cases resolve within 4 to 36 months and 15 months on average. However, Wong et al. In the year 2016 described that complete resolution is unfounded, which is why interventions to regain complete shoulder function might be necessary. The stiff and painful shoulder is identified by a significant and equal loss of both active and passive shoulder movements, but has minimal pain on resistor testing. The shoulder can either be stiff due to stiff tissue or due to a stiff joint in case of osteoarthritis, fractures, or rare locked posterior glenohumeral joint dislocations. To diagnose frozen shoulder in your physical examination, first examine external rotation in the zero position and compare it to the other side. You can do this by fixating the scapula with your body and a coracoid process on the anterior side with your upper arm. An external rotation loss of at least 50% compared to the other side or less than 30 degrees is considered a positive finding. Afterwards, range of motion has to be reduced in at least two other planes by at least 25% compared to the other side. For this reason, it makes sense to test pure range of motion in the glenohumeral joint in abduction, and you can do this by fixating the clavicle and scapula. Followed by the assessment of flexion, and again with the fixation of the clavicle and the scapula. According to a study done by Holman et al. In the year 2015, all patients suspected of frozen shoulder displayed some degree of active muscle guarding. For this reason, it might be helpful to perform the coracoid pain test to distinguish between a true and a pseudo frozen shoulder. You can watch a video about how to do this test in the end card. Alright, this was our video on the diagnosis of frozen shoulder. If you found this video helpful, we would be happy if you could leave us a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't, and check out our newly released assessment ebook for a perfect overview and summary of all of our content so far. You can also find us on physiotutors.com, Instagram, or Facebook. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.